It's wonderful to trust the Lord, to really put all your confidence in Him and really give yourself to Him full way. Not only halfway, but a full way. Give yourself to follow His will and His plan. Are back, and you are back too, I hope. Or maybe this is first time you're looking on us today, but I believe that you will be blessed because you have tuned in this program right now. And if this is the first time, you know, be sure that you press the subscriber button before you left today, and so that you continue to follow new programs. We put up new programs every week that we believe it's a blessing for you to take a part of. What we are sharing is what God has put in our heart, and we will share that with you because we like you to come closer, walk closer with God, and inspire you to go into a stronger flow with Him, a stronger flow in the praises, in the prayer life, in every area in your life. You will increase your walk with Jesus. And most of all, don't forget to read your Bible too, where you're sitting and listening. You know, when we take a Bible verses, you open your Bible and read themself. You know, it's so powerful to read itself. But you subscribe and you will share this with all your friends and push the like button too, that you like it. You know, because that will do so more people will see this program and that we will share more and more. Hallelujah. It's so wonderful. And we really look forward for, because today we're talking about to give myself away. You know, to give your life fully to Him, not only halfway. You know, many times we keep a place for ourselves, a private place, you know, and we are and we give a part to God and say, you know, God bless this and bless this and bless this, but we still have our own area. But God says, give everything that you have. Give it to me, whatever you have, all your life, every part of your life. You know, it's not you that shall fix everything. He says, give it to me and I will help you. Trust in me, have your confidence in me, and let me be leading you in every area of your life, in your work life, in your family life, in your relation and your friends and your church, whatever you are. Some people think, I am with God on Sunday in the church. The rest of the week I take care of myself. You know, God will take care of you the rest of the week, because when you're in the church, hallelujah, you are already with Him. So you know, the rest of the life, that's what God will have of you. The another 6 days, amen? The seventh day that you're already going in the church, you have given it to Him. But you know, give Him all the 7 days of the week, amen, hallelujah. You know, I say, I give 8 days, because that's the best way to do it. You give Him 8 days. You say, no, wait a moment. It's only 7 days a week. Yeah, but if you give 8 days, so you're really sure that you have given everything, so you don't miss anything at all. Hallelujah. And you know, that's, you know, to give yourself. And in John chapter 5 and verse 30, Jesus says this, by myself. He talked about himself. Jesus talked about himself and says that, by myself, I can do nothing. Ooh. If you really give everything to God, you will say, by myself, I can do nothing. I judge only as I hear, and my judgment is just, for I seek not to please myself, but him who sent me. Amen. You know, you and me, we are very fast to judge. We are very fast to have an opinion about everything. You know, we don't use really the word judge, but you know, I like to use the word opinion. Do you have an opinion about everything? And you stand for that. You fight for your opinion. But Jesus says, I don't have my own opinion. I keep to the one that God tells me, that God gives me, that he tells, this is the truth, this is the way, this is the thing that will bless people. Hallelujah. Because when you keep your opinion for yourself, you say, God, if my opinion is not correct, if I am not correctly on my way, I'm willing to change that. So I'm in line with you. Hallelujah. And after that, in Romans chapter 12 and verse 1, Paul writes this, therefore I urge you, brother, in waves of the God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual act of worship. Amen. The next verse says, don't let you be confirmed by this world. But you know, it says this, therefore, I urge you to give yourself. Hallelujah. To give yourself. Many times you stand there in the church and you're singing the worship songs. I give myself, and things like that. But on the same time, you're standing there thinking, what shall I do after the church today? And I need to think about this, about my work on Monday. And you know, you have so many things going on up there. But instead, you can only focus and say, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I am so thankful what I shall doing after the meeting today. You will lead me. You have planned for that. And you will pray on Monday when I go to the work. Oh, God, there will be a wonderful day together with you. And God, help me to say the right things, to do the right thing. God, help me and lead me to really be a testimony for you in my work. Hallelujah. To be a testimony for you to my the people around me. Maybe you're not really allowed to talk about Jesus in your work, but you know, you don't need to talk about Jesus in your work. You can only act, and your action talk about him. Maybe they say in your workplace, he's not allowed to pray here. And you say, that's no problem for me. I'm Christian. I don't need a prayer room. I don't need a mat to pray on and a special direction. I am a Christian. I can pray anytime, anywhere. And I don't need to do it loud too. I can do it quiet. Amen. When I'm sitting there in my work with a computer, and it's a lot of people working around, not right now in the corona time because the office is closed, we need to work from home. But normally it's a landscape and we are 50 people sitting close to one another, the bum, 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 and we're working there. Everyone have our own computer and working and everyone have something to do. And you know, if I, and of course sometimes, mistake, I maybe say Jesus and say hallelujah so they can hear, but you know they are used to me, but on the same time I sitting there, right on the computer, and in quiet in myself. I pray to God, I sing in worship to Him, and you know, it's wonderful. And sometimes I can put the earphones and listen to some wonderful praise and worship. Hallelujah. You know, that's how work life is. Amen. And for the last here, I will tell you, and in the 2 Corinthians 8 and 5, Paul take an example here. And they did not do as we accepted, but they gave themselves first to the Lord and then to us in keeping with God's will. They give themselves. When he come with the gospel and preach the gospel, they was so happy and so hungry, so they give themselves to the Lord directly. You know, sometimes you can be surprised. Hallelujah. You know, that happened today too. You get surprised. They're coming some people and you pray for them. They receive Jesus and suddenly they get so in fire for the Lord. They are mostly more in fire in the Lord than what you are. It's like Paul, he writes here. It was not like we have accepted. We were planning and thinking, but they get wild in the Lord. And you know, and after that, they come to us and they say, oh, show us, train us, learn us how to walk according to the will of God. And you know, that's the most wonderful thing that can happen, that you and me, we are wild to be with the Lord. We are wild to come close to Him, to really give myself, not only away, but to give Him, give it to Him. We give ourselves to Him 100%. God bless you. And see you soon again.